You're watching CES Live, powered by Ustream.tv, the most powerful way to stream live video, and by NewTek, makers of the TriCaster family of broadcast and streaming systems. And now, CES Live.
Hey guys, I'm John P. Welcome back to our continuing coverage here at CES 2014.
Yeah.
I've got Simon. We've changed out our co-hosts.
Yeah, I'm Simon Sage. I work at Mobile Nations. Lately covering a lot of games, a lot of game loss stuff in particular, but there's a lot of great stuff out there.
You already leaked a little bit of our next guest, but hey, why not, right? We've got the guys from Gameloft here. Thanks for coming to join us. We appreciate it. Tom, pronounce your name for me.
Baudouin.
Baudouin.
That's correct.
So that sounds very French to me.
It is very French.
I have a lot of people who have a difficulty calling me Posazides, John Posazides, so I just go by John P, obviously. Yeah. So you got any kind of nicknames?
Yeah, I should. I will.
We call you Bo.
Okay, I like it.
That would be a very Texas guy. I'm from Texas, so you
okay.
know, when you come visit, we'll just call you Bo.
Nice.
Nice.
Okay, I take it.
Well, thanks for coming to join us, guys. You guys are big in the game space, obviously. What do we got today? We got good stuff we're going to show off?
Yeah, we have. We wanted to show you guys our next big games that should launch later this quarter. That's Brothers in Arms 3. And we are very excited because we had really a tremendous success back in 2011 when we launched the last edition. So that's what we have for today.
Nice.
So this is still set in the World War setting? Where's this one taking place?
Yeah, it's World War II. It's Brothers in Arms games. And this time we had a bit different approach, the way we were building the game. We've built a game really made and optimized for touch, really from the ground up. We build a game with touch control. It's more strategic approach. I think that maybe the best would be to have a look at what we've done. But
sure.
Yeah, we'll definitely do that.
It's really awesome.
Well, before we get into it, so when you say it's optimized for touch,
yeah.
First of all, let's talk about which platforms is available on.
Sure. So this game will be launched on Android and iOS, and will also be available on Windows Phone 8.
Okay. Well, that's cool.
Yeah. So mobile.
Didn't forget about the Windows people.
Yeah. Nice.
Yeah. Nice. Now, when you say optimized for touch, what the previous versions you wouldn't consider optimized for touch?
Yeah, it was optimized for touch, but the way we approach this game this time was, it's a shooter, it's a third-person shooter, so we have to decide, okay, what kind of controller we will use in the game. So one option is virtual sticks.
Yeah.
You know,
where
like
you use your thumbs on the screen like this kind of thing.
Yeah, and it works really well. I think that we were one of the first developers to implement this virtual stick like back
years ago.
Yeah, years ago when iOS launched and when the iPhone launched. And then the approach we wanted to have this time was to make it really accessible. Because sometimes, you know, to play with dual stick or virtual sticks, it's sometimes for more core gamers, and we wanted this game to be accessible to the majority of the players. And
so even if I don't play a lot of these types of games, I won't have to be frustrated that I can't control it right. We're going to control it in a different manner.
Exactly, and you'll have a lot of fun. It will be a strategic, but still a shooting. Gorgeous environment, but I think that was what our players liked. The last edition was, you know, the gorgeous environment, and we kept that. We brought it to the next level, and we changed the control system.
Nice.
It should be and the way also we structured the campaign. You'll see there we have 100 level just from the start. It should be it's cool. It's cool.
Great. Let's check it out.
So I'm going to show you a level that's a little ways into the game, and hopefully I think we've got that good. So, and I'm going to try to play this sideways like this.
We'll see just how good you are.
So you'll see right here, this is one of the first screens you do. You encounter is where you apply your NPC, your brother, Brothers in Arms. There's a whole bunch of these guys that are all unique characters. They've got unique attacks, special weapons that they use, and so on. And so this is an early mission, so you only have this one guy to choose from, but later on you'll have more of them to choose from, with, again, like I said, different things that they are capable of. And then you can we can get a better weapon that we'd like to use for this mission. I think we should use something nice and heavy. And then we've got some consumables. I should take a med kit, but I always like to take a rocket launcher.
So is this going to be a freemium then, or?
This will be a free-to-play game.
Okay, great.
Nice. Oh, by the way, did you say when it's coming out? When's it due?
It's maybe later this quarter.
Okay, cool.
So as you can see, it's very much about taking cover behind things in the environment. I'm locking on to guys, shooting at them, but then I'm just tapping to say where I want to go to. So I'm going to go to that next spot that is showing me on the map. I can do things like shoot my rocket launcher.
Oh my god.
And then I can also, like I said, call in my other guy. He's a sniper, so he just sniped that guy over there.
So how do I aim at one of these guys?
Basically, it'll lock on to somebody, but if there's more guys in the environment, I don't see anybody else right now, but when there are more guys in the environment, you can swipe and lock on to the guys.
So that little halo-looking thing over, the little red arc, it tells me that I'm locked on to somebody.
It does. And that's his health bar, too, so you'll see as it goes down.
Okay, and so you're just hitting the little button there to squeeze the trigger, essentially.
Pretty much. And then, I'm choosing which guys to lock on to. I'm making decisions about when I want to move up. See, now I'm going to move, but I can also fire as I'm moving.
Okay. So ditching the dual stick joystick layout is such a good move. You know, there are so many shooter games on iOS and Android that cling to it. It really is a relic of console gaming that I think doesn't really belong on iPad. So this is a great example of a shooting game optimized for touch properly.
Yeah, thanks. I mean, I think that we feel like it's... like you were saying, a lot of people, you know, we don't want anybody to feel like that they're being held back by feeling like they're not good enough at the controls, that it's really, this is about decisions, it's about tactics.
Sure.
I think it says a lot that you're able to hold this with one hand and essentially play it with the other. Yeah. I mean, that does make it easier for someone to be able to control
that. And I'm holding it sideways, too.
Yeah, and sideways. Yeah. Well, that looks awesome. And it is as you were saying, it's a gorgeous environment. It's very attractive. And it looks like very smooth, and it's not even finished yet. You're not even releasing it yet.
No, yeah, we're still working on it, polishing it. That's something that's really something that we're doing at Gameloft is we really want the right level of polish before publishing the game.
Yeah.
And you know, the competition is so strong on the App Store these days, so you really have to come with the right product, and we're pretty confident that this one will be a hit.
Nice. Well, I can't wait to give it a try.
Yeah, me too, definitely. I'm looking forward to that one.
Well, thanks for joining us, guys. We appreciate the preview on that. I hope you guys have a great rest of the show. You guys stick around. We've got even more live coverage coming at you here from Las Vegas, CES 2014. I'm John P.
I'm Simon Sage.
We'll be right back.